Hi everyone, today I've got a little bit of a yoga sculpt for you today. So this lesson or this class, just a couple of 1 kilo hand weights. It is a class where we do basic yoga moves, but it's high repetition. We're just using the weights to build a little bit of definition through the muscles. So as always, just making sure that you listen to your body throughout practice. Don't push yourself too hard. Find this a good place to start with your yoga sculpt. So as you feel ready, coming down onto your mats, just take an easy cross legs. We'll take a moment just to roll the shoulders back and down, closing the eyes down. Just beginning to lengthen your breath. Slowly begin to bring some movement through the shoulders, so just warming the body up before we bring in some more dynamic movements. Nice and be open or closed, just feeling into that shoulder space, feeling the heat. From here, shoulders towards the ears, bring them back and down, then drop the chin towards the chest, and then that nice gentle rock. Chin left to right. And now just allowing that chin to gently rest towards the chest, taking the eyes open. Reach the hands towards the sides. As the hands draw towards the sky, slowly bring your gaze up, reaching nice and tall. Just bring yourself into a forward fold. Remember, it doesn't matter if it looks like this or if you can creep a bit deeper. Just feel into your back space. So hands into mat or ground. A bit of pressure here, big breaths into the shoulders. Hands towards one side, just again working into that side body space. Drawing through center towards the opposite side. From here, hands through to center, walk them in towards the body so that head can rise, bringing your hands behind your hips and take a little flip of the feet out. So from here, fingertips facing forwards, just take a tabletop, drawing that head all the way back. Slowly drawing your hips back down towards the mat, and we'll tuck the feet off towards the back of the mat and the hands towards the front. So again, just keeping the body warm, we're taking cows here, it's chin, chest to the sky, tailbone to the sky, big push into the mat, arching around in the back, working with your breath. Alright, let's draw it up into something a little more dynamic now as you draw through next time, push into the toes, rise the knees from the mat, take a gentle paddle through. That nice down dog shape, hips are high, hands are nicely spread here, looking towards your knees to begin with, and bring your gaze between your hands, foot towards your plank. Bring those knees just gently towards the ground, don't let them touch, core engaged. Now bring the knees all the way down, untuck the toes, slowly send the chest towards the mat, let the chest be heavy here, a big push and rise into your cobra. Cobra out to your widening child's pose. So hips towards the heels, gentle rock left and right, just feel into that space. And then from here we're reversing that action, so you're taking your gaze between your hands, forearms come down, draw the chest along the mat, rise into your cobra and cobra up towards your down dog. Bringing that right foot towards the sky, just take a little bend to the knees and kicking out the heel towards the left side. square through hips, bring that foot down. Left side will reach tall and then that gentle bend towards the knee. And squaring through, bring the foot down towards the mat. We'll walk up towards the top of our mat. So coming up to the top, you can put your weights just really here to the side. So you want one each side ready for your hands. Just take a minute here in a soft forward fold. So it's soft knees, hands to elbows. Maybe a little sway. Taking the time to gently take hold of the weights as you bring yourself to stand. Nice and tall, reaching the arms overhead. And bring the hands back by the sides. So feet hip width apart, drawing that breath in, reaching tall. Exhale, bring the arms by the sides. One more round of that. Big rainbow breath, drawing it in. Exhale, take it down. From here, inhale, raise. Hips back. Into your chair. So we've got our chair posted here. Look towards the ceiling. Feel the glutes engaged. Then elbows in towards that rib space. Just moving the weights back. Chest is slightly forwards. Open those triceps. Got a set of 10 here. Last one here. Bring the hands by the sides. You lengthen through the legs. Your right toes come forwards. Turning the palms outwards is bicep curl with this leg lift. So tapping it up and down again, 10 rounds. Thinking about control. Last one here. So we're going to take and hold. Elbows wide if you can. Just moving the arms and keep that leg nice and static. If you need to bring the toes down, the balance is not there for you today, then feel free to just drop the toes to the mat. Last two. And last one. Drop the arms by the sides. We're going to see if we can float it all the way back. So right foot's reaching back. Coming into that warrior three float. Now it's an upright row, so elbows wide. Floating the back toes down, palms facing forwards, find your high lunge position and take it into 10 lunges for you. Move your bicep curl. By the side, so it's warrior one leg space, so that back heel will slide deep bend to front knee, reach the arms overhead, interlace those weights, bring them behind the head and reach them to the sky. Rising up, heart through the waves, open out wide to your warrior two. Front leg comes straight and draw the arms in and bring it back down. So it's warrior two with that foot. By the sides, send the chest forward, drop the weights to the mat. Bring your hands to the ground, we'll take a stretch here by drawing that left hand towards the sky. Bring the left hand down from here, it's a big sweep of left foot towards the ceiling. Three-legged dog. Left thigh to chest, float forwards to your plank and hover. Draw the left foot tall, three-legged dog. outer chest, float to plank. This time a little tap of knee towards that left elbow, reach tall. Last one here, as we float forwards, this time we find the space of that left foot forwards. Sweep the hands towards the sky, just give those shoulders a little stretch, thumbs come into legs, pull the arms back. And then sweep the hands to the ground, picking up through your weight, coming into our bicep curl with a low lunge rock. Step back to full plank. Knees hover. Engage core. Knees to the ground. Now forearms down. Making a triangular shape on your mat. So elbows, shoulders in line. Pass the hands around where that head is. Then walk your feet long. So your option here is knees down. Or you can lift through the knees into your forearm and hold here for 5 breaths. And then your option, if you wish, to take it a little deeper, will be up and into your dolphin. So the head isn't connecting with the floor. There's a big push into the forearms and hips are rising. You're trying to bring those hips over that shoulder space. Slowly bring the knees down, bring the hands to the mat. Just draw the knees wide, toes together, hips towards the heels. Give yourself a little rest here in your child's pose. Bring the gaze between the hands, rise to all fours. We'll just take 2 cat-cows here to bring us up through that spine. Lift and rise to your full down dog, and you'll make that journey to the very top of the mat. Once you find the very top of the mat, it's picking up through the weights, hands to shins, slowly bring yourselves to stand, with breath in, reaching tall, bring the arms by the sides. So same sequence to the left side. Draw your breath in, reach tall, exhale, release. Drawing tall, and down. Lift and hold here, look towards the sky, big bend through the knees, find that chair, elbows to ribs, chest forwards, taking in those tricep dips. Last 2, and last 1, bring the arms by the sides, straighten the legs. Taking us to our balance. So remember, this is option 1. Option 2, bring it up. Last 2. And last 1, lift and hold, elbows wide. 10 rounds if you can, bring the toes down if you need to. Last 1, take the back toes down, find your high lunge space, 10 lunges with your bicep curls. Last arms by the sides, back heel will slide. Deep bend to front knee, warrior one legs. Reaching back with the arms to those weights. Might interlace, the arms reach towards the sky and then towards the back of the head. Chest forwards, waist to the ground. Bring that right hand to the sky, do that stretch. Right hand to the mat, dropping the back knee, picking up through the weights, slowly drawing it through. I'm going to bring that back down as I've skipped one. I'm going to sweep that right foot towards the sky, three-legged dog. Float forwards, chest to thigh, drawing to right thigh to chest, float to plank and then tap to the right side, draw it tall. Now we're bringing it down, thigh to chest, foot forwards, back knee drops, let's pick up those weights again. Take it into the bicep curl, make your low lunge drop. Down and lift through the hips, walk those feet forward, finding a dolphin. Big push into the forearms, feel the shoulders lift away from the mat, the head's not connecting here. Hands in towards the knees. So feel free to repeat that left and right side three or four times, two or three times, whatever feels nice. But for today, just going to take it back. So back toes are tucked under. We're just going to open and release through the shoulders, hands close behind, pull the fist down, look towards the sky. Reaching the arms up towards the ceiling now, lifting hips from the heels to find a nice big stretch here. Hands down towards the ground, little cock of heels off towards the side. Coming into easy cross legs, just like we began. Hands to knees, bring that chest round, feel into the hips. Stillness for a length to the spine, roll the shoulders back and down, and turn your palms to the sky. We'll just take a minute in stillness.